In Uganda, 13% of persons have at least one form of disability. The United Nations Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disability guarantees persons with disability the same level of right to access quality and affordable health care as persons without disability. However, according to women with disability, accessing maternal health remains a major challenge to them.
It is also on another national duty in the Benzori area.
Rosa Wede, a disabled mother, recounts the unfair treatment she received from one of the health facilities at the time she was pregnant.
When I started my antenatal visits at Wakiso Health Center 4, I was asked to pay 450,000 upfront because I could not give birth normally. There is a time I had a stillbirth, and when I did a CT scan and took it to the health center, I was not helped. I had to proceed to Kawempe, where I finally got help.
Zawede appeals to the government to establish disability-friendly health facilities to enable people with disabilities access them.
We need government to put special hospital staff for the disabled. Also, the maternity beds in these health facilities are unfavorable to us.
Sarah Najuko, a visually impaired mother of two, wants the government to introduce punishment for men who sire children with disabled women and neglect them.
We need a law on men who engage disabled women in intimate relationships. This way, these men will probably not abandon their responsibilities.
Women with disability are also victims of sexual gender-based violence. However, many complain of the unfair treatment at police stations where they report their tormentors.
There is a police officer who asked me to sacrifice a part of my body so as to help me in case I had reported. I could not do it, and I also didn't have money. I had to give up the case.
This was during a stakeholders meeting aimed at improving the livelihood of women affected with disability. Irene Karono from Sense International recommends mandatory neonatal screening for any forms of disabilities.
Ideally, at birth, every child should be assessed and any impairment identified, and once that impairment is identified, to see if any can be corrected, maybe through stimulation support or surgery. And in case it cannot be corrected, to see how that child can be supported to grow so that the other aspects that do not have impairment can be hoped to be addressed.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.